We're asked to multiply and write the answer in lowest terms. To multiply fractions, we multiply the numerators and multiply the denominators. So looking at our notes here, if these are the two fractions we're multiplying, the numerator would be a times c, and the denominator would be b times d. However, the product does need to be in simplified form or written in lowest terms, and we can simplify before or after multiplying. So in our first example, we have 1/4 times 3/5. So when we multiply, the numerator would be 1 times 3, and the denominator would be 4 times 5. But before we find these products, let's see if we have any common factors other than 1 between the numerator and denominator. Notice in this case, there are no common factors other than 1 between the numerator and denominator. So we can go ahead and find these products, knowing the fraction will be in lowest terms or simplified. The numerator is 1 times 3, which equals 3. The denominator is 4 times 5, which equals 20. And before we go to our second example, though, let's discuss the meaning of this product. So the question is, what does 1/4 times 3/5 equals 3/20 mean? Well, it means that 3/20 is 1/4 of 3/5, or we can say 3/20 is 1/4 of a copy of 3/5. Let's go ahead and model this. If we define the rectangle as one whole, here's the model for 3/5. So if we want 1/4 of this amount, we would cut or partition this into 4 equal parts or pieces. So let's go ahead and cut or partition this vertically. So we'll cut this in half, and then in half again. So notice how by doing this, we just cut the 3/5 into 1, 2, 3, 4 equal parts or pieces. And because we want 1/4 of 3/5, we want, let's say, this amount here. So this is 1/4 of 3/5, but if we compare this amount to the whole, we have a total of 20 parts or pieces, and we've shaded 3 of them, which gives us 3/20. This is why 1/4 times 3/5 equals 3/20. Now let's look at our second example. Here we have 1/8 times 4/5. So the product would have a numerator of 1 times 4 and a denominator of 8 times 5. But again, before we find these products, let's see if there are any common factors other than 1 between the numerator and denominator. We'll notice how 8 and 4 do share a common factor of 4, which means this does simplify, and just as we simplified fractions, if it's helpful, we can always write out the prime factorization of the factors in the numerator and denominator, where 4 is equal to 2 times 2, and 8 would be equal to 2 times 2 times 2. We still have a factor of 5. In this form, we can see the common factors. 2 over 2 equals 2 halves, or 2 divided by 2, which equals 1. So 2 over 2 simplifies to 1 over 1 here, as well as here. So now we can multiply, knowing the product will be in lowest terms, or simplified. So we have a numerator of 1, a denominator of 5 times 2, which equals 10. Now there are several ways to show the simplifying. Here I showed it using prime factors. A lot of times you'll see the simplifying in this form here, where if we recognize there's a common factor of 4 between 4 and 8, and there's 1 4 and 4, and 2 4s and 8, we can simplify the 4 to a 1 and the 8 to a 2. Notice in this form, when we multiply, the product will already be in lowest terms. 1 times 1 equals 1, and 2 times 5 equals 10. And of course, we could show the same simplifying in this form here by simplifying this 4 to a 1 and this 8 to a 2. I hope you found this helpful.